Go to python.org and download the latest version. We have 3.10 at the time of recording. Launch the installer. We want to add Python to our path so that we can execute the Python command on our command prompt. I'm going to make a new folder to store the scraper project. I'm going to open a command prompt to this folder. Now I'm going to create a virtual environment to store our Python libraries. A virtual environment is an isolated environment where we can install specific libraries for a project. If we install the libraries to the global Python environment, the libraries are shared amongst all projects, which makes upgrading libraries a big headache in the future. The -m command modifier lets us run a module that comes with the Python installation. We use the virtual environment module to create a new virtual environment called .venv. We can see the new virtual environment created inside our scraper folder. I'm going to go into the virtual environment. Under the scripts folder, I'm going to activate the environment. After activation, we see the name of the virtual environment in front of the command. This means all subsequent commands will apply to this virtual environment. We'll go grab the command to install Selenium. Let's see where Selenium got installed. It's here inside our library folder. We need one more thing to make Selenium work. When Selenium runs, it launches a browser under its control. So we need to download a driver for our browser. I use Chrome, so I'm going to download the ChromeDriver. I need to get the version that matches the version installed on my computer. Looks like I have 106. So I'm going to grab 106, Windows, open it up, and then extract it into the project folder. If you have Chrome set to auto update, eventually the version is not going to match the Chrome driver. So one day your code might stop working. All you got to do is go to the Chrome driver page and grab the one that matches. Now we can open Visual Studio Code and point it to our project folder. I created a new file called scraper.ipynb. This extension is called a Jupyter Notebook. Jupyter Notebook is a way to program in Python interactively. We'll see how that works in a second. Let's make sure Selenium works by launching a browser. We'll grab some sample code. Change this to Chrome. Before we run this, we want to make sure we install the Python and Jupyter extensions. Looks like it automatically installed all the Jupyter and Python extensions right here. Now we want to make sure we select our environment, not the global one, but the one we created. Now we can execute this code. Looks like VS Code needs more stuff. We'll go ahead and install it. There we go, looks like Selenium works.